Late breaking this noon, Winter Springs cops have taken a man into custody, accusing him of making and mixing drugs at his home. The drug is commonly known as K2 or synthetic marijuana. WESH News' Dave McDaniel is live at the Winter Springs Police Department with the very latest this noon. Dave?
Well, you know, Jason, local investigators searched two different locations. They searched the suspect's home and an office they say he used. They say he was in the business of making and selling illegal drugs. Investigators spent a good part of Tuesday at the home on Fisher Road. Police say the photos from inside the home show ingredients for making synthetic marijuana under the bed. And they say throughout the house, there was residue in the signs of synthetic drug manufacture. 22-year-old Patrick Weber was arrested for possession of hallucinogens with intent to sell, possession of controlled substances without a prescription, possession of marijuana, and possession of paraphernalia. At the office on State Road 419, which was also searched, cops say they found all sorts of glass pipes and bongs, which they say are used to smoke the illegal substances. In the garage, they found a cement mixer they say also was used to make the mixture. The chief says this situation is particularly dangerous because items are mixed together in very dangerous combinations.
They're spraying things on there, such as acetone. They're spraying acetone, which is something that you use to clean grease and stuff off of garage floors. And then they're spraying this on our product, and our kids are getting a hold of this product, and they're smoking it, and it's rotting their teeth. It's doing all this other harm to their bodies. And I don't even think the kids realize how serious it is.
And again, while the police chief is absolutely confident that Weber was making and selling synthetic marijuana, they have sent samples to a lab to make sure they get the proper results before they can officially move forward with those charges. Reporting live in Winter Springs, Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.